Today I'll be showing you how to parse sounds in your games, animations, and more. So we're going to be focusing on this block, the pitch block. You might have never used this block before in your life, but you did not know about the secret feature. So what does it do? Well, what it basically does is it makes sounds faster or slower, but it has a limit at minus 360. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna do minus infinity, which will bypass this limit. Then it will make the pitch so slow that you won't even notice it when you click on play again. So let's make this minus infinity block. All you have to do is go to operators, get out the divided by block, and do -1, and calm down, don't go crazy on me, but we're going to divide by 0. And when you click on it, you see minus infinity. So you might be thinking, no, we can't do divided by 0, Seamus, that's wrong. Well, let me show you something. So here I've got the calculator, and if I do -1, divided by 0, guess what happens? It also shows minus infinity. If you just search up -1 divided by 0, it shows undefined. So this is an error in the calculator that lets us do minus infinity. Okay, so now we just put it here, and that's done. But here's the thing, we can still hear the very slowed down version of our song or sound. So what you have to do is set volume to 0%. Let's just get a sound. So I'm going to go to choose a sound, and let's just go to loops. I'm going to choose one of the worst sounds in this library, Bossa Nova. So we have Bossa Nova here, and when the green flag is clicked, we're going to do forever loop, my favorite block, and then play sound Bossa Nova until done. Don't do start sound Bossa Nova, because it'll just forever start the sound, but I won't play it until it's done. So now let's make an actual button. So we're gonna go here, let's just make it black, zoom in a bit, and okay, we have the button, and I'm just gonna add a simple text to it. This button is very simple, but you could make it as fancy as you like. So I'm just gonna say sound on it, like that, and we're gonna center both. Okay, back to code. So when we start, we're going to go to x0, y0. You can change this if you like. And we want the volume to be set to 100% when we start. Now, let's get to work on the button. We're going to use the when the sprite click block. So we're going to need two sets of blocks. One to pause the sound and one to play it. So this is for pausing. And to play it, you just need to do set volume to 100% or whatever volume you want. And then we're going to set pitch effect back to 0. Now we're going to get out the if else block and put it here. Put the volume to 0% in the first part and the volume to 100% in the second one. So we have this volume block. It shows us our current volume. What we're going to do is if the volume is 100%, then we're going to set it to 0% and set pitch effect to minus infinity. So what we're basically doing is pausing it. If it's 0%, that means it's paused. So we're going to set the volume to 100% and set pitch effect to 0, which is playing it. Let's full screen, and yeah, you can hear the music. And okay, thank God I paused it. Okay. See, you can still hear that part of the sound. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you want more hacks like this, then click on this video. You'll love it.